Nowadays, many of us are talking about AI and big data, right? So one of the questions is, how do I invest in this industry and this sector? How can I involve and expose in this market? Today, we will talk about a little bit of the AI. Maybe it's more important than what you think. And also, in the end, we'll suggest some of the assets that you can invest in to expose in this new sector. First of all, if you're new to my channel, please subscribe to my YouTube channel and also like my Facebook page. If you like this topic, please like and share. If you have any comments or questions, please leave me comments in the comment box below. So let's begin. So today, let's review the assets that I talked about in previous Mondays, okay? So the first one is Alibaba. So there has been an e-commerce and a holiday celebrating on November 11th. So we have talked about that we are really confident that the sales may hit 150 billion renminbi this year. So in the end, it's $168 billion this year. And on the first day, Jack Ma said that, oh, it's not about earning money, making profit, it's about learning. Oh yeah, it's about learning, right? That's a huge number. Anyway, we've also talked about the second point is every time in the past 3 years, every time the Alibaba stock price will peak before November 11, that holiday that he made. So we want that, or maybe probably you should sell your stock maybe this year. The peak is earlier and earlier. So maybe this time is end of October or really early November, as long as it's earlier than November 4th, like last year, okay? So in the end, within the first 2 days of November is the stock price peak and coming down. So I think we can still hold the stock as long as it holds $173 per share, it's fine to go, okay? So the second one is about the Adidas, okay? About the sportswear technology. So we talk about that, and Nike really rebounded really quickly, and the target of $54 has hit, okay? So right now you can hold the stock or you can sell it, but if it breaks above $56.50, it can also hit the target $60.40. As long as it doesn't break below $54, and it's fine. The second one is Adidas. Luckily, we drew the uptrend line. So the cut loss level will be really tight. So now it's broken below, I suggest you cut loss and leave the market until it hits $164 per share and rebounded. And maybe it's another chance for us to buy. And again, it hit this level and rebound, it's really likely that it will do so because the sales and the profit is doing pretty good for Adidas. It's just technically, it's not as good. So what is AI? I think the most popular and familiar AI that we've been using is Siri. I'm not talking about what not to talk to Siri at 3 a.m. That is a prank, right? So I'm talking about really Siri. But we know that it's not as perfect as we thought, because sometimes Siri misunderstood our conversation and our questions, probably, but that's at least something that we get a taste of the AI. The second thing is maybe in Japan, there's many robots that start to help you making decisions, okay? That is about the AI. So it's about the technology, the computing versus the human brain. That is the AI. It's not about like the 70s IBM AI, it's not like that. It's not about the algo trading, it's not like that, because anything about math, about numbers, is already existed for really long. We talk about what is AI, what is coming to us within a decade or two. That is something about consciousness, about decision making, about learning, about memories. That is something, for example, if you're making decision on what to have for your lunch, it's something for your taste buds, for your memory, to make you feel good. That is something that is not quantified. So that's why this is what the AI we're talking about. So it involves software and also as well as hardware. So why some of the people outside know that, understand that AI and big data is such a big, huge influence. And some of them will think that AI is just algo, is something that we have heard about 3 decades ago. It's not the same, because we've only looked at the input layer and also the output layer. For example, if you go to casino, you input on the table what's on the deck, and then you calculate the probability of the output. That is not AI, that's not big data, right? Because there's math. That doesn't involve learning, memory, feeling, stuff like that. So we'll talk about there are few hidden layers, and all we'll talk about is there. It's about consciousness, making right decision, about judgment, about learning and memory. So that is the big step. So again, AlphaGo is not something close to what we'll talk about AI in the future, but at least Google is attempting to do that. That is a step ahead. So AlphaGo is, we talk about this 1 year or 2 years before, we talk about AlphaGo a lot, because AlphaGo has played a chess game with the champions all around the world. So one of the champion KG, he was crying and saying that it's too perfect, I could never win this game, okay? So we see that AI is pretty powerful, right? So this chart is about what sectors in the world nowadays will be replaced by AI earliest, okay? So we see high tech and telecommunications, of course, right? And financial services like us will be replaced. I think replacing it majority is correct, but replacing it all, not now, okay? But why? Because they are all about numbers, statistics, it's not about emotions, feelings, and learning consciousness, not like that. So it's easiest to be replaced. In fact, it should be replaced 10 years or 20 years ago, started replacing it, okay? So in other sectors like travel, tourism, healthcare, it's about what? It's about your feeling, your sense of belonging, what you're gonna see, gonna feel good, about memory, even about pain, about health. They're not about quantification, they're not quantified, so that is really hard to replace. But the room to improve will be tremendous. So big companies like Google and Tencent, they are already kicking into these markets. So how do I involve in this market, right? So one of the assets that you have been asking is AIEQ. That is an ETF, a fund that is fully operated by AI to invest for you. So they're saying that investing in that and you should be okay, right? So for the first few days, people are saying that, whoa, really good, right? It's outperforming the market. So really good. So people have been asking me many, many times about this ETF. It's not going to replace. Why? Because of all these algos or the programs we have talked about helping you to invest, it's not the first day out. We've been listening to this for more than decades. It always fell because behind is lacking of one human being to revise and fine-tune the investment portfolio. So it's not always about numbers, right? For example, there's something happened in the world, North Korea doing something, and people panic. That's not about the AI. As long as this problem is not solved, human in this area is still useful. So there are many systems like IB is developing one, and also eToro, stuff like that, they're all doing so. It's not as perfect as you think. So right now, looking at the stock price of this new ETF, it's going down right now. So again, even if it's doing good, the turnover in volume and the popularity is also affecting the stock price. So be careful. It's working with IBM Watson. Of course, IBM, Google, they're doing big data like that to conquer the world. So another group that I admire is Man Group. If you have been in this industry, you understand, you know this company. Before 2008, it's a fund that is doing hedging, and they run by program. It's doing really good, compound 12% compound year to year. So this is something that even though the stock market crumbled, is still profiting 12% per year. So that is basically it. But after 2008, it's doing poorly. So people like started learning investment in this decade may not know Man Group, okay? So for example, the program, there's some mistake and communication with humans. For example, the engineer of this group saw these patterns, these three numbers coming out from the program. These three patterns to the engineer, even to the chief engineer, does not make sense at all. So sometimes it's the communication, it's something that will not replace for now, but it's something that companies are doing for it, and it's exactly why we're going to invest, because there's room to improve. So in the human mankind, we're not the first time seeing the software and what we built are going faster than hardware. For example, in the modem era, for example, in the VR era, because the Oculus is doing the right thing at the right time. But this idea has been patented before the idea of Oculus came out. So at the right time, it means that the hardware is fully supporting what you're going to do. So the hardware is really important. We're talking about CPU, right? So CPU, you're talking about multiple cores. It's pretty powerful already. So we talk about GPU, okay? GPU is thousands and ten thousands of cores. The computing speed is lightning fast, okay? It's something that is really going to support. If you say that the software is developing slowly, that's fine, but the hardware is fully functioning to support whatever you're gonna do. So the monopoly of this technology is NVIDIA. It's talked about they're working for many, many companies. So we also know that the CEO of this company has announced that they're going to work with the taxi in the US, in New York, and also Audi of the self-pilot, self-driving system. So this is, of course, the main technology, main thing that's going to happen within a decade. So we look at the stock price, it's going up more than double last year. So right now, it looks like pretty good. As long as in this technology, there's still monopoly in this sector, the stock price will not peak right at this level. So right now, technically, we also look at technically to be safe, right? So technically, it has broken above the uptrend channel. It's uptrend, it's not downtrend, right? It's pretty powerful. So I suggest you can invest in it now as long as it doesn't break below $202 and it's good to go. The target will be $229 per share. So if you're a long-term investor investing in this company, yes, but you can invest, you can lower your cut loss level to $185. But do not take into this market and buy the stock without a cut loss strategy, okay? So this is something, this doing a business, after all, we need to minimize the risk, okay? So the second company, of course, is Google, right? It's developing the cloud TPU. It's cloud and TPU. What is good about it? It's about, we talk about learning, memory, stuff like that. We've seen the technology, seen the skill done by different companies, but Google has a technology called DeepMind. It's saying that consciousness, learning, memory, and then decision making all in one brain. So they're calling it human brain, okay? So it's a pretty powerful claim, right? So let's see what they're doing. But another research saying that in the traditional accuracy of the learning of AI and computing, the accuracy is only about 42% to 77%. So human can judge and learn up to an accuracy of 92%. So if this technology that Google owns works, the accuracy will be as high as 96%. So let's see what they're doing, but they must be doing something. But this stock is, personally, I'm really investing in this stock. So due to conflict interest, I will not open the chart too many times for you guys, but you can look at my previous video as a long-term investment, long-term decision that you can make. So the last one, if you say, oh, it's too difficult for me to learn, but I understand how big AI will be, I want to invest in something, in the long run, you can consider this ETF. It's called BOTZ, B-O-T-Z, okay? This is an ETF that will be buying different companies in different sectors. So as a whole, you can benefit and expose in this market as a whole, okay? So if you understand the AI really good, I suggest you buy individual stocks, okay? If you don't understand, but you understand the whole idea of AI and big data, then you can invest in this ETF because it's pretty safe. And the first sector they're investing in, industrial. So it's hardware. So the second biggest sector is technology, is software, right? So together it's already more than 80% of the ETF. So don't worry that it's investing in small cap companies. It's 68% they're investing in large cap companies. So in the end, I want you to understand that this is the chart saying that some kind of industry will be replaced by AI. So if you know Mark Cuban, he's saying that nowadays, you're not learning hardware, industrial stuff like that because it's replaced by computers, right? Right, that's good. But it's not about that. You're not learning programmers. It's learning programs that program the computer to replace programmers. So, okay, so it's something that really deep and actually is really urgent for us or our next generation to think about. So if you like this video, remember, click the like and share this video to your friends. And if you have anything to add, please add it in the comment box below. Investing made easy. I'll see you next time. Goodbye.